Greetings, this is Alaje, incarnated from the light dimensions of the Pleiades. Alaje is my Pleiadian name and has nothing to do with anything on Earth. My name is a Pleiadian name with Pleiadian vibration. In the higher dimensions, your name results from the energy you have. It reflects the energy you are radiating and the energy you came from. It reflects the energy from the place from which you have the strongest energetic connection. In the last part, we were talking about real lightwork and real lightworkers in order to identify those who are spreading hate and ego but claim to be spiritual. Real lightworkers are spreading their cosmic light and love out of their heart to help the planet to ascend in a higher dimension where only the energy of love can reach. People with hate and ego who create hate and attack and insult others are not lightworkers, even if they claim it. Those people are mostly influenced by negative entities or still have the negative attitude from past lives. If you don't have enough cosmic love energy in your auric field, but mostly ego, arrogance, jealousy and hate, negative entities can penetrate your auric field and control your thoughts and emotions. The light and energy in the aura cannot be faked. It is the energetic signature of the consciousness that everybody has. A real lightworker can be recognized by the light and love energy in his auric field and by his actions out of love in order to create love. Real lightworkers are talking with love and not with hate. They don't have any jealousy and their actions are based on real cosmic love in order to create love energy. In June 2012, I visited with a group of real lightworkers good energy places in Serbia in order to send healing energy to the place and to the planet. Every lightwork is an inner cleansing meeting, an energy work, to get free from any blocking energy. On every lightwork meeting, we are confronted with high energies from the energy place and from the light beings who are participating. The high light energy will bring to the surface whatever is hidden inside your consciousness in order to see it and heal it. Those energies continue to work after the lightwork. Personal inner work on deleting negative energies is the most important for the personal spiritual development. Reading a book is not enough. A book is only an information. The real work has to be done personally. Everybody is going through this life lesson, whether he knows it or not. Every lightwork is an opportunity to free yourself from negative feelings, negative thoughts, or negative karma. Only when you are free of low energies, you are ready for higher energies and you are able to incarnate on higher dimensions. The meaning of life is to become a loving person with a developed consciousness without ego, arrogance, jealousy and hate. There are lightworkers who are beginners and have just started to work on themselves, and there are experienced master lightworkers who have mastered real universal love and wisdom in many lives and on many planets and had real experiences with the light in higher dimensions. They were initiated from higher light beings and have the ability to carry more cosmic light in their body than others in order to heal and cleanse negative energies on planet Earth. This information is stored in their soul and their auric field as an energetic imprint that can be seen by other spiritual people. Energy is always visible and cannot be faked. Those who are faking to be spiritual masters and are attacking other people out of ego and hate are creating negative karma for themselves and are blocking their development. The real professional experienced light carriers are souls with great wisdom who came to Earth from higher light dimensions by birth in order to be able to act in a physical body. A real light carrier has no ego, hate, jealousy, or other negative behavior and dissociates himself from any kind of hate, religion, cults, belief systems, superstition, or political views, and thus cannot be brought into connection in any way. Real lightwork is not only happening on easy positive places where lightworkers are using the good energy to spread it to the planet. The experienced master lightworkers are often visiting places with negative energies in order to heal and transform these energies with the cosmic light they are radiating out of their bodies. This is called advanced lightwork and should be done only by people with a powerful light and cosmic love in their aura in order to be protected from negative energies. In advanced lightworks, you are confronted with demons and other negative entities who are gathering in negative places. Planet Earth is located in a dimension with polarity, where negativity still exists. Now that planet Earth wants to ascend into a higher dimension, all negative energies have to be purified with positive energy. Positive means using cosmic love, and negative means love energy is missing. There are places on Earth with positive energies, and there are places with negative energies. That depends on the energies that Earth humans have created over a period of time or are still creating. Places with positive energy are vortex places, where cosmic energy is amplified more than on other places. Places with negative energy are places where negative energy has been created by humans or places with volcanoes. Volcanoes are valves or pores where the planet is releasing negative energy. The planet is a living being and it has pores to release an infection just like the human body. Everything is connected with fine matter energy. Every energy has an impact to everything else, to humans and the surroundings. That is not a cloudy mystical thing. That is higher spiritual science that is necessary to know if we want to understand life and how we can live in harmony and in peace. In the last 12,000 years, Earth humans have created much negative energy on many different places as a result out of combination of wars, hate, arrogance, religions and other cults, greed for power and manipulation from negative extraterrestrials and lower astral entities and demons. In the last 13 years, I did lightwork with many groups on many places to clean negative energies on Earth. In March and April 2012, the Cosmic Awareness has sent me and some friends to a long lightwork tour in America to purify old negative energies in Florida, California, and Hawaii. The first place was St. Augustine in Florida, where the brutal Ponce de Leon landed at April the 2nd in 1513. Ponce de Leon was one of many conquerors who were sent in the name of church and kings from Spain to steal riches, to kill and to make slaves. Ponce de Leon and his 200 soldiers conquered Puerto Rico and many places in Florida like St. Augustine with extreme brutality to Native Americans and claiming them for Spain. In order to have a powerful light energy, first we charged our energy in the nature and later with the energy of a 600 years old tree in St. Augustine before we entered the place where the Spanish criminals killed the local Native Americans. As we were walking through this place, I could feel the negative energy and trauma from those actions. Many souls of the killed Native Americans were still there traumatized and could not find the light. The cleansing of this place was very painful. I could feel the pain and sorrow of the killed and tortured Native Americans. I created a vortex of light and the souls could finally go to the light and let go of the old trauma and pains. The years between 600 and 1800, based on the Gregorian Earth calendar, have still a very strong influence on the thinking of Earth humans today. Many superstitions and hate energies of today have their root in those times and are the reason why many Earth humans don't develop cosmic love in their heart and a higher consciousness. In this period of time, Earth humans had hundreds of wars where millions died because of religious fanaticism, superstitions and greed for power, land and gold. Modern historians begin to figure out that the years between 600 and 1800 is the time where priests and kings changed the calendar and the documents about the historical person Jesus many times to match their medieval beliefs and superstitions, and to easily control the masses with fear and scare mechanisms and convince people to follow the church cult. And because these documents were copies from copies from copies, translated from different languages and from many different people, it has been added even more errors, superstitions and misinterpretations. The modern Gregorian Earth Calendar is based on creations and beliefs from medieval priests who set the first day of the calendar on some day that they decided is the day of the birth of the person known as Jesus. Before that, Earth people were calculating the calendar with other belief systems. The modern Earth calendar can only be used for approximate dates in the past 2000 linear Earth years, but it cannot be used for calculating cosmic events in the universe. The cosmic awareness, the source, does transformations and cosmic changes when the time and energy is right. It is not using linear Earth calendars. It is historically proven that the medieval times were the times where the church cult military were torturing and killing millions of humans in the name of an imaginary god and became rich by stealing other countries. Greedy priests and kings from England, Spain, Portugal, Italy, France, and Holland have sent hundreds of killers and criminals to conquer many places like the American continent, many islands in the Atlantic and Pacific Ocean, many places in Africa, India, Asia, and Australia in order to kill, to make slaves, to steal from people, and to force them to follow the church. This is documented very well by Earth historians, and it's easy today for everybody to get this information. Those killers created a very huge negative karma, and they have to clean it in many lives. Just the Spanish conquest killing trips lasted almost 200 years, from 1402 until 1600, and there were many different conquerors with many ships and hundreds of soldiers. In these times, over 100 million Native American Indians were killed brutally in the entire American continent in the name of the church and the greed for gold. Almost 90% of the population died. It was the biggest genocide in the last 10,000 years and created an extremely negative karma to the killers. The Spanish church soldiers flayed them to death by forced labor and massacred them in the cruelest way. They hanged for the glory of Jesus Christ and the 12 apostles, as they said, groups of 13 Indians over a fire so that they suffocated and burned simultaneously. They drove the Indians in pits with pointed stakes, mutilated them, or they dropped their children to be eaten alive by wild dogs. The men, women, and children who survived were forced to obey the church as slaves to satisfy perverted fantasies of priests and soldiers. These hired killers from the European kings and priests were the founders of the modern American world as we see it today, after they almost killed all the Native American Indians. The results of these evil actions are visible until today, and the negative energies are still influencing Earth humans in the mind to act negative. It created thoughts of racism, religious dependency, religious hate, violence, and criminal actions, and it is keeping people from reaching a higher consciousness and social harmony. It would be a sign of wisdom when all religious organizations today and some governments would return all of their wealth to the country which they have robbed brutally and give all their wealth to millions of starving people worldwide, and at the same time disband all their buildings of control, superstition, fear and lies. Today, the descendants of the Native American Indians are living in miserable, poor conditions in deserts where you can't grow anything. In 2011, I visited the Hopi Reservation in Arizona, and I was very saddened to see how the people were living there. The negative invaders forced them to live in deserts where they cannot grow food. When we visited the poor villages, we saw that they are trying to sell dolls out of clay to survive. The land there has a negative energy similar to the lower astral dimension. If you talk with people here, you realize that most have lost the knowledge and the connection to the old wisdom. Most people have been changed by the modern society and have an alcohol drinking problem. The different tribes are divided and separated. If they would unite and concentrate on creating transformation energy, they would be able to change their situation. Here we can see the old saying, divide and conquer in action, because the violent invaders divided the different tribes, separated them from the old knowledge, forced them to learn the language of the invaders, and forced them to live a life of misery, poverty, alcohol, and hopelessness. Evil actions are creating negative karma to those who create this energy, and this karma comes naturally back one day, because it is the universal law of cause and effect. So it's not by accident that there are many natural disasters in the American continent. The planet is trying to clean the negative energies on his body. In ancient times, people were not only be killed in wars, but also for the amusement of the kings, for religious offerings, and those who wanted to see others suffer and die. One of these places was the Colosseum in Rome. Thousands of people were killed here for entertainment and religion. Killed by the sword or being eaten alive by lions. You can imagine the negative energy stored in this place and the thousands of traumatized souls who are still here and can't find the light. So I went here too to do energy cleansing and freeing many souls. Another religious brutal killing in Rome in medieval times was the method called mazzatello. It was a killing used by the papal states from the 18th century until 1870. Those who did not obey to the papal control were executed on a public square in Rome by cracking their head with a big sledgehammer and a throat cut with a knife. Rome is one of these places that need a lot of energy cleansing. That is why I did here lightwork too. On many other places on Earth, fanatic religious people killed and tortured millions of people, and many are doing it until today. This negative energy is influencing the behavior of modern Earth society. In medieval times, between the 13th and 18th century, the church cult established the total control with the Inquisition. Today's historians estimate that they killed over 10 million humans just in the European area. Countless people have been stuck for years in dark dungeons, tortured by instruments of torture, and forced into a confession. Their property was confiscated and fell in large part to the church. Their relatives were mostly destitute on the streets, and no one dared to help them. In medieval times, almost every castle had a torture room to torture and kill those who did not obey the orders of church and military. Many souls who suffered and died in those times are still blocked and traumatized in those places and they can't find the light. That is not a cloudy mystical thing, that is higher spiritual science that is visible to spiritual people. Many of those places need an energetic healing with cosmic love to purify the old traumas and help many souls who died in those times to find the light and continue with their development. Energy does not disappear just because it happened a long time ago. A negative energy can stay at a place for a long time if nobody transforms it into the energy of love. I went to many castles, torture rooms, and church tombs in the middle of Europe in order to help traumatized and trapped souls to find the light. Sometimes it is possible to capture with an infrared camera the souls who are finally free. They appear as orbs of light. Anybody who has a powerful love frequency in his aura should do this cleansing in places with negative energies. We continued our long lightwork tour and we visited one of the best vortex places on earth at Mount Shasta. This is the place where the spiritual Lemurians fled after the destruction of their continent. They are living now below Mount Shasta in the fifth dimension. We came here to charge ourselves with the energy of the mountain vortex and the energy of the Lemurians because we were planning to use this energy later to purify Hawaii, the last remaining of the sunken Lemurian continent, where the old energies of the destruction are still influencing the planet. As we made our meditation on Mount Shasta, we could feel the presence of the Lemurians in their fine matter state. They gave us light energy for the next light work that we were planning on Hawaii. Our next stop in our lightwork tour were the giant redwood trees in California in the Muir Woods. They are 115 meters high and some have a diameter of 12 meters. Those trees store powerful energies because they have stored cosmic energy since 3,200 years. Trees are antennas for cosmic energy. And the older they are, the more energy they have stored inside. At places with good energy, you can take pictures of many orbs. So we came here to charge ourselves with the good energy from the trees. Charged with powerful light energy, we were ready now to do our light work on Hawaii in April 2012. We visited Big Island and Kauai in order to spread our light energy across all the island chain of Hawaii. Our light work was the first real energy cleansing since thousands of years on these islands. If you visit Hawaii and you are sensitive to energies, you will feel that Hawaii is one of the most significant places from past times which still have unsolved negative energies. It is the place where the continent of Lemuria were destroyed in a terrible war with the Atlanteans in the Pacific Ocean. Many traumas and negative energies were created at the end of the Atlantean times because some Atlanteans thought they are gods and they used cosmic energy for wars. Those Atlanteans who caused this disaster have a negative karma to clean, that is why they are incarnated many times on Earth to clean their karma. I met many of those who are incarnated currently on Earth, and many have still the arrogant attitude and are insulting lightworkers who are talking about what they did in the past. The Hawaiian Islands are the highest peaks of the sunken Lemurian continent. The big destruction on Lemuria created a crack on the Earth's surface and the lava started to erupt and the highest mountains became volcanoes. In this disaster, millions of people suffered and died, and the negative energy created there is influencing this planet since thousands of years. In the Pacific Ocean, we can find many places with negative energy, like the cannibal islands of Fiji, Samoa, Papua New Guinea, and Hawaii. The negative energy on Hawaii attracted many brutal warrior tribes from Polynesia around the year 700, and the wars and brutal rituals they had there attracted many lower astral entities and demons. A sentry who neglected his post might have his brains bashed out by a superior or be executed by strangulation. An enemy captured in the battle might have his entrails removed and every bone methodically broken while still alive, so that his body could be bundled up and carried off the field as a sacrifice for the demons they were praying to. Wars were continued since 1819. Because these islands are remote and far away from populated places, the old energies could survive there for thousands of years because there were not enough other positive energies to purify the old negative energies. Many local people are still living the old rituals of superstitions from the past because many of them are reincarnations of the past inhabitants. Of course, there are some exceptions on these islands too, but they are not enough to clean the negative energies. First, we visited Big Island, and the only positive energy that we could feel here were the dolphins at the two-step beach and some untouched places in nature. Before you meet dolphins, you should meditate and create the right energy. Dolphins are sensitive to energies and can read your mind and feelings. Swimming close to a dolphin is one of the best experiences you can make if you meet them with cosmic love in their heart. We spent the first day swimming with the dolphins and playing with the sea turtle. Thank you. The next day we went to the south of Big Island to Green Sand Beach. The beach is green because the sand consists of green crystals. So we meditated there to use the crystals as a magnifier for our light energy. At night we were meditating at South Point, where we saw some lightships of my light brothers again. The next place we visited was the Pololu Valley, where we connected with the nature and charged ourselves on trees with small vortex energies. We used the energy to do a cleansing meditation again. After our energy work, the weather became too stormy to continue with the cleansing. If you use a powerful light energy to cleanse a place, you will often notice that the nature will help you with the cleansing power of wind and rain. On Big Island, a sensitive spiritual person can feel and see many demons that are staying at many spots around the island in the lower astral dimension, along with many deceased Hawaiian warriors, because they were attracted from the cannibalism, brutal sacrifices and wars of the past inhabitants. Those negative entities are influencing many of the modern inhabitants to act with hate and take drugs because they feed on negative energy. One of these spots is the castle at Pu'u Kohola Heiau. When we sat down to meditate and send light, many deceased Hawaiian warriors started to attack us and were trying energetically to push us down the hill. With our light energy, we could stay safe and free hundreds of victims who were killed in that place but could not find the light to leave the place and were held back from the agent warriors and the negative entities. The negative lower astral entities on Hawaii did not like the light that we brought with us, and they attacked us many times, either personally, energetically, or they were influencing negative people to attack and threat us. Some of those who were influenced and attacked us with furious hate were local people who claimed to be spiritual, but in reality they have heavy ego and hate energy stored inside, and that is why they were manipulated by those negative entities. In a negative place, you can test your degree of spiritual consciousness. You can see for yourself if you have a powerful loving energy or not. If you have a higher spiritual consciousness with real cosmic love in your heart and no ego or arrogance, no negative energy can manipulate you in order to create harm to others. If you have ego, arrogance, envy, jealousy and other negative emotions, you are an easy victim for negative lower astral entities or lower astral parasites. And there lies the lesson that possessed people with ego have to learn. Many unspiritual people are channeling evil disguised entities from the lower astral dimension, but they are not able to recognize this and falsely think that they have contact with light beings or spiritual extraterrestrials or with Jesus or other spiritual teachers. I met Jesus in the astral dimension many times, and he is very saddened that many Earth humans are misusing his name in order to satisfy and justify their lust for ego, hate, jealousy, war, and control over others. No spiritual being wants to be worshipped because that is against the cosmic laws. Channeling is not a sign for being spiritual. Channeling is only a sign that somebody is receiving energy from other beings. I have seen very evil people who could channel demons on purpose. I have seen shamans in Mexico and Nepal who were possessed by demons. They had no control of their actions and were screaming to others with hate. So channeling is not a sign for being spiritual. To be spiritual means to use cosmic love energy in the heart, which needs to be developed with training and wisdom over many lives. People who are channeling have to be very careful and aware of whom and what they receive information. If you are channeling a demon that is disguised and claims to be Jesus or a spiritual extraterrestrial, this entity will tell you to go against loving people, against lightworkers, against people who are promoting cosmic love. If you are channeling this kind of entities, you will have hate and arrogance in your consciousness, and you will use it to harm others in order to feed and satisfy the entity. The last day on Big Island, we did a long meditation at the Spencer Beach, where we charged ourselves with the energy of the sun. A sun is a portal where the energy of the source comes through. In this meditation, first you meditate with closed eyes, and when the sun is lower and red, you are looking directly inside the sun and you absorb the cosmic energy through your eyes. You fill yourself with cosmic energy and you are ready for the next light work. After 6 days of cleansing on Big Island, we went to the island Kauai. If you visit the island Kauai, you can sense a slightly better energy than on Big Island due to the fact that most of the island is not inhabited by humans because there is a rich vegetation. At the outer edge of the island, we experienced many spots where deceased people from ancient times and many demons are living since thousands of years on this island because nobody started to cleanse this energy with real powerful cosmic light. We visited many places around the island. In the beginning, we went to places with good energy in the forest to charge ourselves and be ready for the negative places. Another place with good energy was the beach called Secret Beach, located in the north. It is called like that because it is hidden behind a forest. Only after you follow the path down through the forest, you can reach the beach with no tourists and natural energy. The next day we visited Ke Heiau Beach. Here, hidden between the forest, you can find a plateau over the beach with old ruins. In ancient times, people have been practicing here brutal sacrifices and killings, so you could feel the negative energy radiating from this place. With the help of light beings, we started to send light energy to this place in order to clean the energy. The demons, who were controlling this place, did not like this and started to attack us. In this moment, if you don't have a powerful love energy shield in your aura, those entities can penetrate in your energy field and possess you and use you to attack the others. Many people on Earth who have ego, arrogance, hate, or take drugs are controlled by demons and they are threatening, insulting, harming, or killing other humans. A loving spirit or person can see those negative entities hanging in their auras. Demons can be seen only on lower developed planets. That is why it is very important on Earth to have a high frequency of cosmic love in the heart and aura as a protection. Love frequency is a protection force field around the body and keeps lower astral negative entities away from your aura and your consciousness, and you can focus on positive actions in life. After our cleansing, a whale appeared and thanked us for the energy work that we did. If you want to do advanced lightwork where you cleanse negative places, it is very important to have a real powerful love frequency without hidden ego, arrogance or other hidden negative emotions. If you lie to yourself, you can get possessed and you can bring yourself and others in danger, because you will attract what you are radiating. If you want to be spiritual, you have to be honest to yourself and others and work on your inner blockages or negative emotions. In a lightwork meeting, the energy of cosmic light will reveal any negative energy that one has may hidden in the consciousness. In a meeting with real lightworkers, the energy is accelerated and you have the opportunity to learn many lessons in a short time that you normally would go through in a period of many years. A lightwork meeting is energy work, and you have to realize that you will face lessons that your soul wants to master faster. This can be also activated even by just being close to a real spiritual teacher. Spiritual teachers are vortexes of cosmic light, and their energy works even when they don't say anything. Many people don't like it that the energy of cosmic light unmasks them and brings everything to the surface. So they start to attack and insult the spiritual teacher and others, and they create more negative karma that they have to solve in the next life. Hate, ego and arrogance is always blocking your spiritual development. It is creating a life of problems and diseases in this and the next life. If you don't heal the old negative energy, you repeat many lessons in many lives until you master the energy of cosmic love in the heart and consciousness. That is how the cosmos works. It is a cosmic principle of the existence. The next day we wanted to do a boat trip to Kalalau Beach. Here we experienced drunken boat drivers who even offered us drugs. They were controlled by the entities of the island with a mission to bring us in danger on the sea. If you do advanced lightwork and want to clean negative places, you often see negative entities who are controlling this place and want to attack you, either directly or by using other people with negative energy. In difficult situations, you can see for yourself if you are really spiritual or not. In easy situations, many people may pretend to be spiritual, but in difficult situations you can see their real energy. There are many tests in life and many teachings that everybody goes through in order to master real spirituality. If you are in difficult situations and you keep your love energy and compassion in your heart without hate and ego, you have mastered the lesson. If you are in a difficult situation and you act with ego, hate, arrogance or jealousy, it would be wise to start working of deleting the negative karma in this life, because the energy that you have in your consciousness and heart will determine the situation of your current and your next life. So it is wise to start to use cosmic love in the heart and apologize to everybody you have caused harm and pain. Despite the evil attacks from demons and extremely negative people, we did energy cleansing on many spots on Big Island and Kauai with the help of light beings. But because there are many layers of negative energies on Hawaii, many real lightworkers should go there and clean as much as they can. There are many other places on Earth with negative energies that need cleansing in order to create loving energies and a peaceful society on this planet. Some places we can visit physically, and in some places, like places with war, we can send energy from the distance. Our Lightwork tour in March and April 2012 was a big success, where we created cosmic love energy in order to heal planet Earth. We helped many souls who were blocked since thousands of years in negative places to get free of all traumas, and they could get back to the light, where they can plan their next incarnation and next level of development. Earth needs a lot of energy healing on many places with old and new negative energy. On higher developed planets, there is no negative energy at all. That is why they are in tune with the cosmic awareness and are living in joy without any problem. This could be possible on Earth too, if everybody would use cosmic love in their heart and nobody would use hate or ego anymore. It depends always on the behavior of a planetary civilization, if the planet is a place of harmony or a place of disasters, violence and suffering. Everything is energetically connected in the universes with fine matter cosmic energy. Your thoughts, emotions, and actions are energy and are creating the reality that you see around you. Being in tune with the existence by using universal love in daily life is the meaning and lesson of life.